And here we go with another 10-minute precision modeling challenge in Blender. This time it is inspired by 3D Zane with this awesome model right here. I really love it. It's so simple, it just works, and it's something that I want to see if I can recreate really quickly in Blender. So go check it out, go download it over there. It's linked down in the description. The only prep work that I've done for this video is this little guide here. I just wanted to check that when I did my 3D printing that I was gonna get a perfect fit with my bits. So this was just progressively bigger holes, just by a little bit, so that I knew what the perfect fit would be. With that all said, let's get ourselves over to Blender. Let's set up the timer here. We have 10 minutes on the clock. 1, 2, 3, go. So I know that what I need to start off with is probably just the main shape of the body, and I'm actually going to use the default cube. Isn't that crazy? Am I going to use the default cube? Not really, because I don't know what I'm going to be working with. So let's create a circle. First of all, we'll bring this down to 6 vertices, because that's all that's really needed here, because that will give us that. And then from here, I'll take this into edit mode, select it all, turn on CAD transforms, do a scale, and we're going to go from this edge to that edge. And I need to do not a two-dimensional scale like thus. And I need to set this to 6.7 millimeters. And that there should be it. Let me just do a quick check that that is 6.7. It is indeed 6.7. And that there is 6.7. Double checked everywhere. Brilliant. I'm now going to set the geometry to the origin point like so. And I'm wanting to put, I think it was 4 of these next to each other. So let's jump straight into arraying here. Am I going to array? No. What I'm going to do first is create the geometry itself. So let's select this, F. Then we'll go face, extrude up by 10. Brilliant. There we go. And now I'll go and do the arraying. So we'll go with an array. And what I'm wanting here is a constant offset, I'm pretty sure. And if this is 6.7, what I want to do is add 2 wall thicknesses. So that should come to 0.84, I think, is the number. I think that's the magic number. I'm going to go with that for the magic number. That should come as 2 wall thicknesses, and I'm going to have 4 of these along this way, and then I'm going to grab another array, and we're going to do it this time of a relative, I think. Maybe, yeah, well, I don't know. Let's go constant, because I'm not sure. And let's go Y this way, set that to 0. And let's just take a top view. This is not going to be as precise as it was in the other one. What I will do, though, is get pretty darn close. I think something like, oops, I'm getting lost here now. So we'll move about here, move this to about there. And then I'm just going to, I don't know, let's add a millimeter. Yeah. So let's go plus 1 millimeter. And that did not do what I wanted, but that looks like 7.7. Let's go 8.7, 8.5. That should be more than enough right about there. Let's go 8.7 just in case, because that's what it looked like it should have been. And I'm going to go with 9 of those, because that's how his design or her design is with 3D Zayans. So we'll apply that and apply that. I'm then going to grab these faces and extrude them up once again. Am I going to extrude them up? No, I'm not. I'm going to undo that last little extrusion so I don't have that problem. But now I have an idea of what this is going to be like. So I'm going to move the geometry to the origin so that this is centered up. So then I don't have to do as much work at this point, because I can now get my cube. I can scale this up. Here we're going to be, what's that going to come to? That comes to 20. So I'm going to go with 30. I want about a millimeter, maybe 2 millimeters either side of this. Yeah, 2 millimeters with a 1 millimeter base. Let me just quickly think this. So that would be a 1 millimeter base with 0.4. Yeah, let's create the base first and then go from there. So that's just going to be 31 then. And then with this 31 now in place, I have my vertex snapping here. I'm going to grab this face and let's just go GZ, snap that to your base there. Go to this top one, GZ. Let's snap that to here, but then go GZ and bring this up by two. No, I'm going to go with the slightly different design than they've gone with. I'm going to go with 9 here. Yeah, that should be more than enough. And then I'm going to grab this one here. I'm going to extrude this out to that point here. I'll go E, extrude that out by 1. E again, extrude this out by 2. Then I will go over to this side here. I will extrude this out. I don't really need to extrude it, but I just feel like I want to extrude it. Let's go this way and that way. That is looking good to me. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shift D this, hide one of them, grab the other one of these, select this, go X, go limited dissolve. So I don't have all that extra fluff and stuff here. So with that now done, this is the one that I want to be using later. So let's go Alt H. We'll have 2 here now. One of them will is this one. We'll hide. This is the one that has that. And I'll be able to click, control minus. That's going to give us this. And now we need to deal with how high this is going to be. I haven't even measured the height of these, which is probably pretty bad of me. So let's just quickly get a little measurement off here. We've got these at 25, I'm pretty sure. Zero that out. 25, yeah, 25. So if we go for 30 high, that is more than enough. So let's just see. If that is 9, we're going to extrude this up by whatever. Wow, my brain is just not working. 21. 21, fantastic. So we have this set like so. And let me just think what else is missing here. Well, I'm going to carry on with this shelf here. I'm going to grab this edge, shift B. We will bevel these down by, I think, 10. It's pretty nice. No, probably a bit too much there. I'm going to go 5 millimeters, segment this to 50, have a nice curve like so. That's looks good to me. And about that old other box here, you know what? I do not need it. And I've also realized that I've forgotten to do this bottom bit. Almost got caught out by that. So let's quickly fix that now. I'm just going to grab that, go GZ minus 2. And I'm going to grab the base of this now with my selection here. All of you guys, please, thank you. We're going to go GZ minus 2. That's nice. And now let's select these faces here. Go Shift D, part selection. So we have this one right here. And I'm going to go back into edit mode here, grab these, extrude these along to the back over there. Now this is way too tight of a fit right this minute, but I do want that face. I want all of this here. But what I'm going to do instead is select everything, go Alt S, scale it out with another S, and we're going to go by, usually my printer goes by 0.4, so I'm going to go 0.5. Yeah, 0.5 on the minus. Like thus, that should give me plenty of room for my printer. I just know that my printer isn't exactly the best calibrated out there. So I'm going to grab my faces here. G, Z, oh God, I'm getting lost. How much time is left? Oh God, I only have 1 minute left. What on earth? Okay, did not manage my time that well this time, but we're gonna get this done. I believe in us. A little bit. So I'm just going to select this. We're going to, oh goodness, I don't think I'm going to do this in time. Am I not going to do this in time? My first failure, but you learn. Solidify, 1 millimeter. Let's go outwards, please, like that. And the last thing I need to do is add a hole here before the time runs out. Cylinder, let's make this 15 divided by 2. and set that to 50. Go X, Y, X here. Rotate this 90. And that will be it. Boom, 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 boom. Minus that. Oh, I didn't make it big enough. Come on. Scale you on the Y. Take a breath, Jonathan. That is a poor hole, but I'll probably update that to have a little handle because we have 30 seconds left. Maybe I can... Okay. We're going to change this up. We're going to add the handle instead. We're going to go 90 degrees like that. Just that little bopping pin like so. Go like this. Go from the top view. I don't know if I'm deleting the right area, but that's going to be it right here. I'm going to scale you. Oh, goodness. Have I really screwed that up that badly? And I've got to stop there. Oh, so close. So close. But just for the sake of it, let's finish the design, because if not, it's a little bit pointless. So all that was really left is we could have scaled this on the Y. And I'm going to scale this to 0. And then I can just go G, Y, bring this in to wherever that's going to be. Bring everything back here. And instead of taking away now with this Boolean, I would add with the Boolean. So where are we? Let's just remove these, remove this. We're going to grab this one, grab here, go Control Plus instead with the Boolean here. And you will see that we pretty much had it. Yes, it's probably not the absolute best thing that we could have done here, but it's pretty darn close. And oh, it's such a shame. Oh, and what happened to the Boolean with this one? Have I messed this up in some way? I don't really know why. Could be to do something with the normal. So shift N. Could be that there's two. Oh, I just removed the Boolean, didn't I? That's why. There we go. The Boolean is still there. So it is working. It's pretty parametric, so to speak. Faux parametric, because you could just change all of this right this minute. So let's just quickly apply all of this. I will make this just a touch smaller and also maybe not quite that gradient, because it shouldn't really, that's not that 3D printable, that's why. So let's just go grab all of that. We'll scale it on the X, make that a little smaller like so. I will also scale this on the Y and bring it a little bit more like this. So then we won't have that many problems with it. G, Y, bring that into about there. And we're still going to have problems right there, but it's semi-3D printable, I guess is the best thing I could say. I still want to edit this, so let's just sort that out. I just don't like making something that doesn't really work that well. Like, it needs to be functionally well. If it's going to be a pain to print, at least make it functionally work. So that would be that. So let's just quickly apply everything here. I'll quickly save my file. Grab this, we will now apply it all, and we will go over to this one here as well and apply all, remove all of our Boolean objects because we don't need those. I'm going to rotate this now on the X like so, oops, R, X, 90 in the other direction, brilliant. I will go G, Z up. GZ, bring that to about here, because this is basically how this is going to get printed, like so. So let's grab these, bring them into the slicer, and check them out. And here we are inside of Prusa's slicer, and as you can see, it's all going to come out absolutely beautiful. So let's quickly give this a slice, see how it's going to turn out. Turns out exactly as I expected, with that wall thickness of 2 right here. I quite like this extra stability for my base. It's just a personal preference. And also, I know that in a workshop, well, the dust is going to get into those little cracks right there, and I'm not really about that. hope you enjoyed that and you found this interesting. If I was going too fast or you didn't know what was going on, remember that I have my free course that's linked down in the description, and I also have my paid course that is just the nuts and bolts, exactly what you need to get started with 3D print design within Blender, and that's also down in the description. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and your support means the absolute world to me. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here, you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we do have a Discord, and that's linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.